what you are going to see now is interesting heading, which I saw today, and the heading says, no other in command, Major General Yoel Stryk warned Sunday the reality of war between wars can become a real war. So, very frightening a little bit, but it looked to be the true thing, because in other places they say clearly that very likely a war with Iran will come out this year. So this is exactly what I wanted to see. And this is a table which I found. However, it is interesting that once in the Torah I found Tavshin Ayin Chet, 5778, Iran coming here. And I looked for this year with Iran on war, because the next idea was not only Iran, but Iran with war, and came here clearly, Milchama. Amazingly, this verse, Ki tabo milchama be'asachem, when a war will break out in your land, and as is written, Bizvum, Asar asorer etchem, amazingly, exactly what we are saying about Haman, Asorer, Asorer Yehudim, exactly the same thing on Iran, today, exactly the same thing. So what you should do, so the Torah says, V'ayotem b'chasotrot, you should blow the trumpets, and v'nizkartem, but this you will be remembered by God, and will be, noshatem, will be saved from your enemies. Now, so amazingly, as we say, this verse, which according to the Sifri, is the war of Gog u'Magog. And Balaturim says also the numerical value, the Gematria, Tavu Milchama is Milchamet Gog, the war of Gog. So clearly showing connection with this war is Iran to do with Gog. And Gog also appears here parallel, which is also significant. Then what you have here in red is Matityahu. It is not me, but this is Matityahu Hashmonai Zazmeniat. And this is based on the idea which means Sashar bring others, that Chanukah is from the word Chinuk, education, preparing. For what? Preparing for the war in future with Gog u'Magog, which will be exactly in the same conditions like it was with the Greeks. And clearly, one can see it really, that at that time this war was in the land, it came out in the land, and also it was physical war, definitely, with the Greeks, and so spiritual also, because it was a war against the Jewish values, the Torah values, against the Torah, against the circumcision, all these things, exactly, unfortunately, today we have also this demonstration on Shabbat, against keeping the Shabbat, they want to desecrate the Shabbat, and definitely against sanctity of man and woman, which exactly that they had to fight in the time of the Greeks. Amazingly, exactly the same story about the war, which was in Matityahu in Chanukah, is now the war that we have in Israel. Yeah, the Israeli coming every time. And also with Iran. Now, what also is important to point out, as the major commander said, it is really Iyum, is a very threat. And this threat is from Gog. Now the question what Gog had to do with the Iranians. Now a very interesting idea about the idea of Gog. Some the name Gog represents powers of arrogance, of pride. The letter Gimal, Gava, Gog. It can be really S is written anybody, any nations which are fighting against Israel. And this is what the Gemara says, that God wanted to make some Kerib quite a while ago, as a Gog, and to make Chizkiyahu as Messiah. But because he did not praise God, did not sing to God for the great miracles that happened, 185,000 soldiers who came to destroy Jerusalem died in one night. So because of this, he was not Gog and Chizkiyahu no Mashiach. So for here some learn that the Gog can be really any generation, any leader who is against Israel. So very likely the idea that it is really coming here and also parallel, which is quite significant, as Professor Rip said, indicating that this kind of war with Iran has to do with Gog u'Magog, as you have clearly The verse speaks about this. Also very important to point out that you have there the Amalekite, which is this is the evil nations which order to wipe Israel, Amalek, a nation to lick the Jewish back like a dog. And also, unbelievably, you have really together the evil angel of the Amalekite is Hasamael, minimal skip in the Torah. Together, this is a masculine one. Its power is, as we said, arrogance and so on. But you have also this together, the feminine, which is the Lilith, which is really the evil angel of the Arabs, of Ishmael, lust. You have really lust and arrogance together, which unfortunately this is what we have. This kind of sins of lust and arrogance, dedicating the Shabbat, definitely, all this is to do with this. And also, the unfortunately sexual matters, as we know quite well, that this is not so kept properly, especially in the army. So amazing, you can see so clearly the evil forces behind all this danger to Israel for a war of Gog and Magog. But as we are told, that who will save us from this war? Messiah, if Mashiach. And which Mashiach? The son of Joseph, Ephraim, Nisraim. So altogether, looking at this table, as we say, it minimal, once again, it was this Tavshinayin Chet, Iran, and war, which exactly fits with Gog and Magog, also very important, this connection. But also important that is written there, V'areotem b'chatzotzot, you should blow the trumpets, and you will remember and will be saved. Now, the Maimonides, the Rambam, learned from here that it is a great duty to do tshuva, to repent in the time of war, which is really more than normally. So amazing, you learned exactly from this verse. Now, also interesting indication that it speaks about the time today, because written Kitavo, El Eretz Moshvatechem, that you will come to the land of your settlements, Asher Ani Noten Lachem, that I give to you, not United Nations, but not Trump, but I give to you. So you once believe in God, definitely then you will have great salvation from this very, very, we know quite well that it is, if it will be a war, it will not be a simple one, you know, with all these missiles of today. So we'll have really to do tshuva, to repent, and then we have Mashiach, very likely Mashiach Ben Ephraim, will save us.